River Plate against Boca Juniors. I'm your commentator, Peter Urie, and providing his unique brand of expert analysis, here's Jim Beglin.
Thanks for the intro, Peter. I've been soaking up the atmosphere, and I'm really looking forward to what lies in store.
Things have got underway here pretty promptly. And a shot!
Again, let me mention what a wonderful stop the goalkeeper pulled off there. Really wonderful.
Looking to break out here.
Peter, we can only applaud that quality of tackle in the circumstances. It was probably goal-saving.
It's Scocco! Has gone out. He's made sure that that won't get through. Can he score? And the ball's come out. Can he finish? There's a goal! And it's River Plate who go in front.
River Plate are really pouncing on any strip passes in midfield. We're talking seconds from interception to the back of the net. It's counter-attacking heaven.
River Plate give themselves a perfect start. Can they build on it? Scocco. Crowd called for him to shoot. Shoots! He's got away with one there.
That's what all good teams do these days. Pressing from the front is highly effective.
Over to the left, with a delicate ball, and a header! He's done very well to get to that.
Well, what can I say? Truly wonderful goalkeeping.
And it's Scocco. Loose ball, who's going to get there? Forward it goes. Now it's Scocco. Dashing foot-faced, and he put it away! And he's there to make a great save.
Keeper really dug out his defence then. A magnificent effort.
Up for the header! Looking close for goal! He has done it! And they are disappearing out of sight! Perfect placement, the one place the keeper couldn't reach.
Now that's what I call finishing, right in the corner. He knew instinctively who was fair and didn't need to waste any time weighing things up. That's a cracking goal.
River Plate take a two-goal lead, and things should be comfortable from here on in.
Well, that second goal has given them so much more command and confidence now, and they should be able to take it on from here and either add to the...
And the referee brings the first half to close. What have we learned from the first 45 minutes?
Well, it's looking pretty straightforward, Peter. They've got themselves into a very good position, so why dither from here when they can repeat their first half success with another show of strength?
River Plate sitting pretty here at half-time, 2-0 up. So we're already into the second period. He's through, it's 1-on-1! And through to the goalkeeper. Tevez. Early stages of the second half, and still two between them. That's one way of trying to make things happen. There's a few who could follow that example. He's got away. Oh, it's a foul, and the whistle's gone. There could be trouble here. And for now, the referee is keeping his cards in his pocket.
Well, I think the alternative was to stand there and do nothing while he tried to score. And obviously, he's not going to allow that, Peter.
Tevez! It's broken loose. Good defending, albeit from an unexpected source.
Well, they say that your front lads should be that first line of stopping the opposition, and I think he's taken it to another level with his desire to get...
Has a swing at it! They are rampant! And the lead is three! It is surely done! That was glorious. Pinpoint accuracy.
You know, what was notable in that, Peter, was the fact that he didn't try to last it. He chose placement instead. And delivered a peach.
Three without ply. This is becoming a stroll. And it's Tevez. Skoko has a look and plays it in.
What a goal!
It goes to show he is human after all.
River Plate were again presented with an opportunity to break and look very, very threatening.
Boca Juniors making consecutive changes here. That's a poor kick by the keeper, he's just given it straight back. He's left his man. Ball's loose, who's getting there? Tevez. Plays it forward. Now a chance break. That a foul? Yes, the referee's given it.
Yeah, and the referee told him it was coming, and he still failed to heed the warning.
And it's Tevez.
Yeah, that's top defending in preventing him turning, which can...
Fires from distance. Gave it a go, but off target. Boca Juniors, their final change.
Well, for me, this was the obvious substitution. He'd become just a little jaded, and as a result of that, he was most likely to make a mistake. I think sometimes when the body becomes tired, the brain goes with it.
Belts one! And he should have made it four. Plays it out to the wing. Tevez sticks in a foot to win it back. And that will be the final act. River Plate, a class apart. Opponents torn apart. They are comprehensive winners. The end of the game. Reflections?
River Plate made their intentions clear that nothing else but a win would do. These games are all...